We found a German player that won the Dutch national championship. That might sound a little bit confusing, but it makes sense in just a second. Leonhard König is here. Congratulations.
Hi, thank you.
He's been my partner in crime for the coverage of the German national championship, which was a real pleasure.
For me too.
And I didn't pay him to say that. And this weekend, of course, you're going to be playing as a national champion.
Yeah, sure. Like, I wasn't asked to be in the caster, so...
Would you have preferred to do coverage?
No.
There we go, yeah. Yeah. Okay, that's fine. We give you that. So, the Dutch Nationals, walk us through it. How did it happen that you decided to play in the Netherlands instead of Germany, and how did it turn out that you won the whole thing?
Well, first off, I started casting a few smaller tournaments, and then I thought maybe I could get into the German Nationals coverage, which I eventually did. So, I decided to play a different Nationals, which was the Dutch Nationals, because I like a lot of the Dutch players. Mm-hmm. It's such a nice community, and I think I won the event because of my preparation, because Sky Strikers just came out and we did a lot of playtesting, and I found out that Trickstars have quite the good matchup against it, and I ended up beating every Sky Striker I played.
So if the people would have been slower to adapt the new deck, your chances would have been worse, right? You basically, you put money on the fact that everybody's playing this deck and you're going to be the
exactly.
one.
Yeah. I knew there were like top players in the Netherlands, like Oosters or Naven or Vandendop. And yeah, they all played Sky Strikers. Well, not Oosters, he played Gookie, but still.
Yeah, the majority.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Right, and well, it worked out, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So this is probably the big gamble for this weekend. What do you expect the big decks to be?
Like the most dominant deck recently was Sky Striker Tricksters, but as people figured that out, people started to adapt again, and I think Goki is going to be the best deck for sure. For 100% is Goki going to be the best deck.
If you have a deck that consistently beats Goki but loses to Trickster Sky Striker, what would you be playing?
I would pick the deck that beats Trickster Sky Strikers, because I think that not all the people are preparing that much for the events as some people do. And then again, a lot of people bank on the fact that Sky Striker Trickster has been so dominant, so they are just going to play it because they think it's the best deck, and then they are playing against Goku and they suffer.
Right. Sometimes if you're two steps ahead of the metagame, you're basically one step behind.
Yeah, right.
So what are you playing this weekend?
Goku.
Okay, so you're 100% set on this already?
Yes. I also playtested a lot against the Trickster Sky Striker, and it's just brilliant. I mean, the deck is, the first turn boards are insane, and you can just OTK if you're going second. It's crazy. You can OTK through Scapegoats by using the Firewall Bounce that is used for bigger combos and good negations to bounce away tokens or monsters on the board and then just ram your wrestlers into your opponent's.
What is the key thing about Goki? Because I heard a couple of players that say, I really like the deck, but you have to think of a lot of things, and the longer the tournament goes, it's going to be harder to be in that place of you need to be to make use of all of those combos.
I mean, the first combo, the most important combo is the Firewall combo. You're basically special summoning a ton of monsters next to your Firewall Dragon to get more and more special summons with the Firewall Dragon to have more and more of your nightmares, which make give you the extra link and Trigate negations. But if you don't have your standard combo for your first turn because your opponent has interruptions like hand traps or he started with trap cards, then you will have to adapt to that situation and you will have to work with less and less cards to have the best possible outcome, and that is what makes the deck really hard.
So I guess you tested a lot with that, of course. Are there any modifications that you applied to your deck to give you the edge?
Yeah, I mean, I'm a big fan of Yu-Gi-Oh! GX, and I'm playing three copies of Neospatian Aquadolphin, because this card gets rid of hand traps. I'm playing Drag Down by the Grave to get rid of hand traps when I go first. I'm siding that one, though. And yeah, I think the decklist I have is really good. I'm probably going to scrub out anyways, and then everyone is going to laugh at me because I'm X3 and
it's,
trying to play
it's
win a match.
It's the curse of the national champions.
Yeah, I guess. I'm really afraid of that. But actually, I'm positive I worked hard for this event, so I think I can...
Right. It's not your first time in Berlin. What do you like about the city?
I love the city. This Sony Center we have with the Dunkin' Donuts place and the cinema, it's great. The whole atmosphere of the city is very nice.
It's also one of the most international corners. I mean, you have a lot of tourists there specifically, and it looks really nice, the architecture and everything.
Right, the architecture is great.
Okay, well, good, good. We baited out another Berlin compliment. It's one of my things for the weekend, basically. All right. Your neighborhood is it Bochum? Is that correct?
Originally, yes. I'm right now living in Ostwestfalen, but I'm a Ruhrpott boy, so.
Okay. So usually when I ask the guys the question where should we hold a tournament in your neighborhood, what would be your reply? Is it Bochum?
You should hold a tournament in Paderborn because I'm living there and then I don't have to travel that much.
Okay, maybe you're going to be in Paderborn. I think everybody else is just collectively looking that up on Google Maps right now. All right, best of luck this weekend. Thank you so much, Leo. And we're going to be back with another national champion in just a second.